At a gravity-defying 5-degree angle, the Leaning Tower of Pisa is lucky it didn't end up as a pile of rubble. So why does the Leaning Tower lean? Well, the original foundations were just 20 metres squared by 3 metres deep and set on soft, marshy ground, not ideal for 14.5 tonnes of marble on top. It'd be a bit like creating an 8-tier wedding cake and putting it on a tiny thin plate and balancing it on fresh bread dough. Now, interestingly, the original architect didn't actually put his signature on the tower, probably because he knew the project was doomed from the start. Now, pretty early on in the construction of the tower, the builders realised that the tower was actually leaning on the lower levels, so they actually created the upper levels at a slightly different angle, going straight up. So if you look at the profile of the tower now, you actually realise it curves ever so slightly, a bit like a banana. But still, despite the best efforts, over time the tower continued to tilt and tilt and tilt by a millimetre every year, until in the early 1990s, it was so much at risk of toppling over, because it was over 5 degrees in angle, that they actually had to close it to the public. Experts knew that they had to come up with some sort of solution, otherwise it was just going to topple over. So they came up with a temporary fix, which they called the corset and the crutch. And the corset was basically a sort of metal structure around the really vulnerable part of the tower, while the crutch was 10-ton lead weights put on the ground next to the northern side to sort of counterbalance the overhanging southern side of the tower. The experts then realised they needed to get engineers to create a more permanent solution. Now, the outer wall and the inner wall of the tower are made of marble, but in between those is a cavity filled with rubble. So the engineers injected mortar into this cavity to bind the rubble to the marble. They also created a drainage system, basically because the water table kept fluctuating, so this made sure that it didn't do that, and actually the ground stayed more stable. They also closed all the wells in the local area, again, so that water pumping didn't create vibrations in the ground. And finally, they created an anchor system with 10 steel weights about 45 metres down below the tower, and then injected liquid nitrogen down into the soil around that to try to freeze the ground and make it really solid. But for some reason, it didn't work, and the tower literally overnight started tilting more and more and more. In a panic, the engineers piled whatever heavy stuff they could find, from diggers to cranes, etc., onto the northern side, the base of the northern side of the tower, and slung steel cables from the top of the tower across to the nearby cathedral. Then they went back to the drawing board and they decided they needed to dig out the foundations from underneath the northern side in order to make the foundations level. So they removed, in the course of a year, about 100 kilograms of soil. And it worked. The tower only leans at about 5 degrees now. Now, I've actually been up the tower, and as you go up, you really do feel it leaning and get thrown against the inside wall as you go around the northern side. And as you come around the southern side, you get thrown against the outside wall because of the gravity. But the view from the top is incredible. And the engineers claim that the tower can survive another 3 centuries. Well, we'll see about that.